Welcome back to Snowflake ASMR. Today we are continuing with our bedtime story series. Today's book is Clifford, the Big Red Dog, the Big Island Race. Today's book is from Scholastic Incorporated. Says Clifford was created by Norman Bridwell, written by Meredith Russo, illustrated by Jen Oxley. It was story time on Birdwell Island. Miss Clayton, the librarian, was reading to Emily, Elizabeth, Clifford, and their friend Samantha. The story was about astronauts on a mission to the red planet Mars. "I wish we could go into space," Samantha said. "Let's go on a mission to Mars," Emily Elizabeth exclaimed. Just then, the girls' friends, Jack and Pablo, skated past. "We love your space book, Miss Clayton," Pablo called. "We are going to be the first astronauts on Mars," Emily Elizabeth told them. "Not if we get there first," Jack grinned. "It's a space race," Emily Elizabeth declared. "The first team to bring back a red stone from Mars wins." Jack hopped on his skateboard. Pablo gripped the handles of his scooter. Emily, Elizabeth, and Samantha climbed onto Clifford's back. "Astronauts ready?" Miss Clayton asked. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off! Whoosh! The friends were off, and the space race was on. Clifford was quick, but Pablo and Jack whizzed past him down the hill. "They're getting ahead," cried Samantha. "Don't worry," said old Emily Elizabeth. "We have a big red rocket. Clifford, it's time to blast off." But just then, Clifford spotted a man with a tasty-looking sandwich. His tummy rumbled. "Clifford, there's no time for a treat right now," Emily Elizabeth yelped as Clifford veered towards the sandwich. Clifford knew Emily Elizabeth was right. A real astronaut wouldn't stop for a snack in the middle of a mission. With a burst of speed, Clifford caught up to Jack and Pablo. Now the friends were nose to nose, neck to neck, scooter and tail. Miss Ellerby, the Birdwell Island crossing guard, blew her whistle. "No scooting or skating in the crosswalk," Miss Ellerby warned the boys, "and no running on the sidewalk, Clifford." "Yes, Miss Ellerby," the children said reluctantly. The friends started on their way again, but with Miss Ellerby watching them, the race was super slow. That was until they reached the park. Then it was go time. Clifford's doggy pals, Bailey and Tucker, were playing in the park. "Hey, Clifford, do you want to come play with us?" they called. "I can't play now," Clifford yelled. "I'm on a mission to Mars." "I don't see Jack or Pablo," Samantha realized. "We must be winning," Clifford panted. He was getting thirsty. "Clifford needs to refuel," Emily Elizabeth told Samantha. Let's make a quick space station stop at my parents' shop. At the seashell souvenir store, Clifford lapped up water from a dog bowl while Emily, Elizabeth, and Samantha borrowed some binoculars. Hi, honey. Emily Elizabeth's parents waved at the girls. No time to talk, Emily Elizabeth explained. We're racing Jack and Pablo to Mars. Well, you'd better hurry, Emily Elizabeth's dad pointed. Jack and Pablo are sailing away on their spaceships. We have to beat them, Emily Elizabeth exclaimed. Come on, I know a shortcut. Be back on Earth in time for dinner, her dad called. Emily Elizabeth led Clifford up a steep, rocky hill. It was hard for the big red dog to balance with so many slipping, sliding rocks. This galaxy sure looks a lot like Rocky Point, Samantha said. Soon, the friends had made it over the rocky terrain and slid safely down to the sand dunes on the other side. Had their shortcut worked? Emily Elizabeth looked out over the bay through the binoculars. There! The red shores of Mars are in sight. But so are Jack and Pablo. They're almost at the red rocks on the beach, Emily Elizabeth cried. They're going to reach Mars before we do. Earth? Not if I can help it, Clifford told Emily Elizabeth. The big red dog rocketed across the sand dunes. His big paws sent sand flying everywhere. Go, Clifford, go, Emily Elizabeth and Sam Samantha cheered. Jack and Pablo tied up their boat just as Clifford reached the last sand dune. They're going to make a run for it, Emily Elizabeth shouted. But we can win if we run really fast. Go, Clifford! Clifford took a flying leap off the sand dune, but when he landed, his legs sunk straight into the sticky Martian mud. Emily Elizabeth tried to push Clifford out, but it was no use. He was trapped. Come on, Emily Elizabeth, Samantha said. We have to run. Emily Elizabeth wanted to win, but not without her best friend. It's not worth winning if I have to leave Clifford behind, she said. Suddenly, Jack and Pablo ran up. I guess you two win, Emily Elizabeth said. Clifford's stuck. Racing is no fun if there's no one to race against, Pablo said. We'll help you instead. Together, the friends pushed and pulled, tugged and towed. It wasn't long before Clifford, the big red rocket, was out of the mud and back into orbit. As the sun set, the brave explorers headed home. Welcome back, astronauts, Miss Clayton greeted them. The friends proudly produced their Martian treasures. A red rock straight from the surface of Mars, they said. This is out of this world, Miss Clayton said, impressed. But which team won the race? Smiled at her friends. When you all work together,